My name's Kory Kroft. I'm on faculty in the Department of Economics in the Munk School of Global Affairs and Public Policy. This year, I will be co-teaching microeconomics for policy analysis with Stephan Heblich. Microeconomics is a foundation course with a focus in economic theory. The course objectives are twofold. On the one hand, the course aims to provide students with the tools in order to better understand and predict the effects of public policies on individual behavior. Secondly, the course aims to provide students with economic literacy and improve comfort level with economic language and arguments. The course itself is divided into four sections. In the first section, we review the theory of consumers and consumer demand. In the second section, we review the theory of firms and how firms make their production decisions. In the third section of the course, we bring together consumers and firms, allowing them to interact in a market setting and focus on the market outcome or the allocation of resources. And then finally, in the last part of the course, we focus on the normative properties of the market outcome, in particular, whether the market reaches a desirable outcome on its own or whether there's scope for government to improve welfare on top of the market. Okay, so one example where the tools of microeconomics could be very useful is in understanding the trade-offs of government policies. So take, for example, the Canada Child Benefit. As we discussed in the course, there's a trade-off associated with such a policy. On the one hand, the Canada Child Benefit, which is a cash transfer to low-income households, is good from an equity perspective because it reduces poverty at the margin. On the other hand, there's a potential cost to the program, which is that because households have more cash on hand, they might have less incentive to earn and they might cut back on their labor supply and reduce their earnings, which drives up the cost of the government. So this is a nice example of a policy application where the tools of microeconomics can be used to understand that fundamental trade-off. Okay, so now is a time more than ever where government is very much involved in the day-to-day decisions of households, and it's therefore ever more important to understand how government policies are impacting both individual decisions and affecting their welfare. And this is precisely why it's a good time now to study economics at Munk.